old son. Cup your ear at that.
Morning all, it's match day. It's Crystal Palace coming to the London Stadium today, which is obviously special for a number of reasons. Firstly is because Big Sam is going to come back and he's going to want to turn us over really and prove the owners wrong for not renewing his contract. But there's been some other bits and pieces that have happened as well. So this is the first game, it's the first game since Piatt announced his bombshell. So it's going to be really interesting. Expect the fans to be really behind Slav today. So they'll be cheering Slav, booing Sam. Really funny. I've actually, it's freezing. It's free. I'll show you out the window. It's freezing cold today. That's outside. I mean, you've seen worse snow in your life, but that's from a couple of days ago. It's very, very cold. It's -4 outside. So, gonna be a very, very cold day, and we're actually starting quite early. I'm actually coming. I'm coming with my best mate, who was best man at my wedding. So I've had to stay over here tonight because the trains are running from my usual station. They're finished. So thank you to Hampshire Hammer for letting me know, because I wouldn't have known. So I'm staying here today. We're going in from Leatherhead today, but my friend is a Crystal Palace fan, so been friends for years and years and years and years and years. It's his first experience at London Stadium. We're going down the barges, so he's going to have a, hopefully have a lovely day, but then for the 90 minutes, it will be war, that's it, there's nothing. My friendship stops, basically, and hopefully we're going to turn them over, because I'm actually coming back here tonight as well, because the trains are not running all day, so I'm staying here, so it's going to be unbearable if I have to stay here tonight, and West Ham have lost to Crystal Palace, so hopefully that's not the case. Anyway, I'm going to have a quick cup of tea, have some breakfast, and then we're going to set off. So I'll see you later. Right, noisy doors. We're on the train, as you can see. This is Marcus.
Boo!
He's a Crystal Palace fan, best man at my wedding. Dodgy character. Are you confident?
Of what?
Well, do you think your team's going to win?
No.
Who's your danger man?
Let's hope for Townsend to have a good game and stick on Benteke's head for the goal.
Townsend onto Benteke's head. Well, Lanzini today. We need Lanzini to be our creative force. We're going to the boats now. We're going to meet Luke and a couple of the other lads down there. And hopefully we're going to have a few drinks, get merry. We're going to be very friendly. And like I said earlier, then for 90 minutes, nastiness.
Between us.
Between fights, fisticuffs.
Perhaps. Little pinches maybe on the leg.
War, dead arms.
Yeah,
dead arms for that. Yeah. And there you go. So we're going to walk through Stratford now. I'm not going to film that. Westfield. The next time you'll see us will be on the boats. Right, here we are on the boats, about 3 hours before kickoff. We're going to find out what everyone thinks. Wayne, big nasty Sam coming back.
Yeah, mate, yeah, my old favourite.
What do you reckon?
It's going to be a bit frustrating first half hour. You know what it's going to do, wind us up. But I think we got enough. 2-1, I'll take that. Come back here, send him in the bottom three. Job done.
Okay, they'll be in the bottom three. We'll be hitting the bottom. Yeah. The bottle, should I say? Not the bottom. Paul? Dimitri Payet, any messages? He watches all these.
Pack your bag and clear off.
Pack your bags and clear off. Jay, speak loud, you're a long way from the mic. What do you reckon today?
We're going to win. Convincingly. Yeah, the team are going to really come out and show Payet that we don't miss them.
We don't miss Payet. Looking forward to Big Sam, Gio?
No. 2-0 West Ham. I think we'll win 2-0. 2-0. Comfortable.
2-0 West Ham. Yeah, 2-0. Marcus, we saw earlier, he thinks, and we're going to have a chorus of boos. Marcus thinks that Andros Townsend might put the ball on Benteke's head for a Palace win.
Big Sam's first away win.
Oh dear, yeah. Sam's not one in four.
Let's get him in the water.
Martin, what do you think?
Won't be easy. Won't be easy today. Reckon 1-0.
1-0 to West Ham. 1-0 to West Ham. Luke, what do you think our last few days, mate?
Shameful, mate. Really sad. Really sad as a fan. Today's going to be difficult. It's going to be scrappy. Wet surface. Lots of sliding tackles. Heard Antonio's doubtful as well. So it's going to be a tricky one, I think.
I didn't know Antonio was doubtful.
Yeah.
Is that insider knowledge?
It's not insider. I think it's common. I've seen it, it's gone through Twitter, I've seen it.
Okay.
That'll be a big miss, but it's 1-0.
Actually, I'm going to have a quick look outside, because Luke said it was wet surface. It's absolutely miserable today. It really is miserable. And it's cold, really cold. In fact, I'll show you now. Right, I'm not being funny, it's all right. Look, got one, two, jumper, three, t-shirt, four, then thermals on underneath. I'm not mucking around. Big woolly socks as well. What do you reckon, mate?
I reckon it's going to be a 1-0 win to West Ham.
Do you?
Yeah, probably.
You sure? Who's scoring?
Ayew.
Really?
Probably.
Is it Ayew?
Yeah,
He's at the African Cup of Nations. You can't play.
Well, not here.
Pick another one.
Antonio, I think.
Antonio. Let's hope so, mate. Dom, we got Dom here, mate.
Good day.
Yeah, how are you?
Freezing cold.
It is cold, mate. It's cold. You got the scarf, though. Thoughts on the last couple of days?
Awful.
Awful?
Because it's a shame, because we've had a couple of good spells over the last year. It's our worst fears, really, confirmed, because we've seen good players come and go in the past. But it was inevitable, really, because we all knew Pyatt wasn't the player he was last year. But I think people got to get off his back a bit, to be honest, because they've got very short memories, look at the ones he did for us last season. Excuse me. I don't agree with what he's doing, but to be honest, I don't blame him, because it comes from like a circus.
So what do you think about today? Do you think Sam's going to torture us today?
I don't think he'll torture us, but I think he'll scrape a win. Because I predict this, I'm a realist. I'm predicting this based on the record we have at home at Crystal Palace in the last few years. We haven't beaten them at all in the last three. They've come to us and won twice, and they got a draw last season, even though they're worse than we're at our best. That draw last year was a turning point. It was as good as a loss. But then we go there, face a win.
We did.
The
it sort of
swings and roundabouts, you know, but they got two strikers that we could do with.
They do. I'm fearful of Benteke. I think that'll push Andy Carroll back into defence for us. Andy Carroll will be defending in our box as much as he is attacking today. But anyway, listen, mate, enjoy the day. I hope you do. I hope you don't lose.
Yeah,
I mean, better, you know.
I'll likely prove wrong.
Well, hopefully, mate. Hopefully. Cheers, mate. Right, there we go. I'm going to grab a bite to eat. Quick word, fellas.
Hello, mate.
Victory today?
Yeah, I reckon 2-1 today. Yeah.
2-1?
Yeah.
Heart says 2-0 West Ham. Head probably a draw, I think.
Draw, yeah.
Hopefully the team isn't too unsettled from last couple of days.
Yeah, it's a real weird one. Allardyce coming back, the Payet business. It would have been weird anyway, but the Payet thing's thrown it.
Yeah, it might bring them together, though. You know?
Hopefully, it's one or the other.
I'll get bad egg out.
Talking about bad eggs, we got a load of nice sausages. There, look at that. There he is. That's what it's all about. Get yourself down the boats, look.
Get yourself some good food.
I'll tell you what. That's it. I'm finished. I'm going to drink some beer and eat some burgers. Right, there's some serious stuff going on here. Mark's taking his coat off. Right, we've got, hold on. We got Mark, we got Jay, you are Team Red. We got Marcus and we got Ethan, you are the blue team. Are we allowing spinning or not?
No, there's no spinning involved, come on.
You can't spin.
I'll tell you what, anything goes apart from table tilting because there's drinks on there, all right?
Oh, there you go, spinning's allowed. Yeah,
so come on, get it in. Mark, come on. Let's go.
Get going.
Here we go.
Oh, push
it. Oh!
It's off the
boat! Oh, dear! Oh!
There is a slope.
Just to let you know, the boys here are a man down. Dimitri Payet, the table football version, is refusing to play.
No back passing.
Oh no! It's an absolute whitewash. It's an absolute one. I'm going to turn the camera off.
Zaza,
there he is. You can actually see. He's a guilty person. That's it. I'm going to have to turn the camera off. It's an embarrassment. Okay, we're on the boat, sorry.
It's their fault. It's their fault, okay.
The boats are very busy. The team news is in. Look at that, can you see out there? We got 200 odd people there today. The team news is in. What's the team news? Someone tell the camera the team news. Yo.
I think it's Adrian Nordby and someone else out. Randolph back in. Collins is at right back.
Speak louder. SSC.
Yeah. Caleri's on the bench, which I find confusing. But probably the strongest squad we could put out, I think.
Mike, anything to add?
I think he's going to play two up front. I think he's going to play. Antonio and Carroll both up front.
Do you? You don't think Antonio's a wing back?
I think he'll play.
Hold on, booze! Sorry, Mike, I got a cough. Booze! Someone's booing! They're booing.
I am an idiot, I quite agree. A professional one though, I get paid for it.
There we go.
Sorry, Mike.
Beautiful. Okay. Team news, Payet's not playing.
Yay! We've got Payet.
No! Boo! On our way to the game now, there he is, the sneaky Crystal Palace fan, trying to sneak in. Nicky's there, Gio's there, we're on our way. Team, well, you've seen the team, you've read the team. We don't know, by the time you watch this, you'll know the result, never mind the team. So, he thinks it's a goal.
Sam's doing his
first. You don't
win.
Want to hear any more Benteke. You don't want to hear any more Townsend. You want to hear about Lanzini. You want to hear about an Antonio winner. So I'm going to turn the camera around, give you a couple of seconds to look at the vast numbers of people that are here. It's been a very, very popular day today. I'm just in here with Gio and Nicky, and they've just said they've actually got security guards stopping everyone going near the Dimitri Payet sign. I mean, this is brilliant. I didn't even notice until...
Paint over it! Paint over it!
Nicky thinks paint over it. I didn't even notice until Nicky mentioned it. The security guards are stopping people. Maybe they're going to urinate on it. I don't know. There you go. Maybe there's a Andy Carroll sign somewhere else. We could hear bubbles being sung in there, but we're a long way from the doors here. Let's hope we can get in by kickoff. Right, we were in a queue for ages. I'm running up the stairs. Never a good video when you're running. Okay, here we go. Blimey. There we go. It's still 0-0. It's still 0-0. Come on, West Ham. We missed bubbles. Right, mate.
Right, mate.
Yeah, good, you. There you go, mate. Sit yourself there. There we go. We're in. Okay, we're 9 minutes in. Interesting formation, but there are a lot of men back for Crystal Palace at the moment. So they've clearly set their stall out to defend today, and we're going to have to see if we've got the invention to break them down. Things have brightened up a bit. It's still quite cold, but it's It's a bit of a, to say sunny day would be stretching it, but it's a little bit better than we thought it would be. Okay, 15 minutes in. They're playing very defensively. We're playing very defensively. It's a game of cat and mouse, to use an old cliche. Not an awful lot going on. It's very, very cagey. Nice little mazy run from Lanzini, trying to make things happen. He looks like pretty much the only creative force in the team at the moment. Just want to say, the Crystal Palace fans making lots of noise, you know, fair play to them. But they appear to have a drum in their section. And
how do you get that this, Stuart?
All I would say is, whilst that's very good and very nice for them, I'm not sure we would have been allowed to stand up all throughout the great game and have a drum. And it just sort of creates an impartiality in the atmosphere. There you go. I don't know if you can hear it on the microphone there. I'm only using a handheld camera. They're making an awful lot of noise, and a sort of level of noise that we are just not allowed to make. They're stood up, banging a drum. I just think if we want to have a comparable atmosphere in here, then we need to be allowed to bang a drum and stand up ourselves. Okay, the stewards appear to have located the drum. It's all kicking off over there at the moment. I don't really know what's going on, but it's not good. You'll probably be able to see this better than I can, to be honest with you, because by the time I've uploaded it, it's going to be on a big screen. But something's going on over there. I think, reading between the lines, the stewards have confiscated their drum. What I would really like to know is, and sort of getting back to the game, is, bearing in mind I probably couldn't have got a Mars bar in here, how someone has managed to get a drum into the ground. Because we've queued up and missed the kickoff by 6 minutes. I don't know. Strange. Someone seems to have managed to get a drum, a guitar and a keyboard in, but there you go. Great opportunity. Andy Carroll just placed it just over. Possibly the best chance of the match. Kick. Carroll has just been hacked down. Free kick to West Ham. All we need is a specialist free kick taker. Show them how it's done, Chrissy boy. Hold on, that's not Cresswell. Oh. Hello, he's missed it. Come on. Throw into West Ham. Oh! Shot from Mark Noble. Gio, what are your thoughts on the game so far?
It's a bit boring. 40 minutes in, nothing much happening except a half chance for Carlo. We're lacking something. We all know who we're lacking, but it's the same amount of players, whether he plays or not. I think there's a lot of nerves. I think we need to get in at half time, regroup, get a bit of confidence going in that change room, and come out and start playing some better football in the second half. But the players need to step up and forget, leave those nerves in the changing room.
Yellow card for Carroll. Frustration. I just think it's just frustration, really. You'll have, by the time you see this vlog, you'll have seen it on Match of the Day anyway. Looked like a silly thing to do. I think the team are frustrated. We are playing with one up. He's very, very isolated. 45 minutes, 1 minute of additional time. Where is the gum chewer? Where's the big fella? Where's Jabba the Hutt? I can't see him. We've got...
Here he comes.
Hello, is he?
Yeah.
Oh, he's coming. He's coming, apparently. Oh, he's there. He's there. Sorry. There he is. It's been mostly Bilic out on the touchline this half, trying to galvanise and motivate his troops. To be fair, we could do with something a little bit tactical, a little change, something a bit more creative. Antonio's tried hard, but
pretty much that was I was quite indicative of what's happened so far. He's tried hard, but we're lacking a bit of technical ability. Half time, 0-0. Right, this mob are struggling. It's 10 minutes into the half time interval. No one's got a drink yet, and the simple reason is they will not pour the pints. They will not pour the pints before someone's ordered. So someone orders, and then they'll start pouring from the bottles, which you might be able to see behind there, into the glass. I just don't understand why they don't pour 300 pints into glasses and just serve them. This queue would be gone. It's an absolute joke. Start of the second half. Let's hope we see a little bit more quality. Byram has come on for Ogbonna, Gio has just told me. Okay. Corner to West Ham. 51 minutes, we've had a switch of formation. Lanzini is about to take the free kick here. He's going to sort of swing it in with a bit of a curve on it. Come on, Lanzini. He's obviously popping it up to Carroll. Hello, 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 Andy Carroll. Oh! Sorry, somebody asked me about our the view from our seats, which you can see the view there, but if you look down here, that's what it also looks like. Somebody was asking me the other day. I don't think he's watching the game. But yeah, there you go, that's our view. It's a really, really good view, actually. We're a lot closer on the corners than the people are at the centre of the pitch. So we're really happy with our seats. We'll be renewing. Anyway, Aaron Cresswell clearing. There you go. It's a foul. It's a foul. And I guess it will be a free kick to Crystal Palace. Okay, Collins took a little knock from Benteke there, it seems. Nothing really, just 50-50. Hopefully Collins is okay. He did a really, really good clearance there. Byram seems to be settling in at right back there. Wow, okay. A little bit of an attack there. Shot flashed across goal. Sam Byram growing into the role there. Thank you.
Super seven village.
Intense couple of minutes that was. We scored, they were not even sang. We sang a lot. Support for village has been pretty much unanimous. Crikey, not been a good game to watch. Not good. 1-0 up. 70 minutes. They've taken Townsend off. Who cares? Surely a penalty, ref. For Gooley's just been hacked down in a very nasty fashion. Momentum surely with West Ham at the moment. Nice effort. Lanzini, Braden Antonio combined really, really well. Just shot over the bar. Looking okay. It's tight. It's 75 minutes at the moment. So Crystal Palace could easily get another goal. But let's hope. We need this. We need this win. Come on. I've got to say, I've been Byram's not biggest critic. But I haven't been convinced by him, but he's done a couple of really good tackles in this game since coming on as a substitute, so well done, Sam Byram. In my voice, the vlog is gonna finish very soon. If ever there was a more ringing endorsement for Slaven Bilic, well, you've just heard it. Fantastic, full support, the whole stadium singing as one in support of Slaven Bilic. 2-0 West Ham. Loves it!
3-0! 3-0! Come on! It's exactly what we needed! I tell you what! Manuel Lanzini, the bubble machine, might not be functioning properly, but West Ham are doing okay. And Fat Sam, where is he? Come on, Lanzini! Lanzini! Lanzini is going off to a hero's reception. Sulky! Sulky, sulky old Sam! Go on, Sam! Drink it up! Cup your ear at that, old son! Cup your ear at that! Argy bargy in the last few minutes. Andy Carroll, man of the match. I'll tell you what, that was a lovely finish. A highlight reel finish earlier on from Andy Carroll. Was it the second goal? Was it the third goal? I think it was the second. I've lost count. This is our record win at the London Stadium. Very, very happy. Randolph dressed in luminous orange. Come on, West Ham.
They find a job. Fortune's always hiding. I've looked everywhere. Oh, I'm forever blowing bubbles, pretty bubbles in the air. United!
Right, Crystal Palace got a free kick. It's gone past the 90th minute. The referee sprayed his Lynx Africa down on the pitch. We don't care. Even if they score, we still win 3-1. I'm just going to film it for you because it'd be rude not to. But most of the Crystal Palace fans have gone, as you can see there. Someone wearing number 7. It was rubbish. Go on, clear it. Referee has blown the whistle. He's blown the whistle. West Ham have won 3-0. Just before we finished, there we go, I just thought it was quite an impressive view of the old stadium. We're going back to the boats now. It's amazing, actually, how many fans we've got, to think that was pretty much full up today. A lot of the games have not been full up, actually, but I do think today there were probably pretty close to 57,000 fans in that stadium. And that's an impressive thing for little old West Ham. But an important win today. Let me flip the camera around. A very, very important win today for West Ham. We couldn't have Allardyce beating us. There's no doubt about it. We could not have Allardyce turning up with his sort of smug cupping of the ear and all that stuff that he does. We also need to send a message out because of Payet. And we showed with Antonio and Lanzini that we had a bit of creativity and we could do something. And I'm very, very pleased for Bilic, who seemed to be close to crying at the end. Hold on 2 seconds. Look at this way. Bilic seemed to be, I'm sorry, I'm trying to jog here to get across to get to the boats. Bilic seemed to be close to crying at that press conference and he deserved it. He's a good man, decent man. Sorry, excuse me, thank you. We'll jump over here. There we go. Crikey. There we go. I'm up on the benches here. We're about to go to the boat. I'll give you a little view of all the fantastic West Ham fans. There they are. I've already said it once, but until next time. Liam! You alright, mate?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah.
Hey, that was good, wasn't it? What do you think of that?
Oh, it's a cracking result. I mean, considering the first half, you sort of thought we might mess this up, but second half they come out, a bit of renewed confidence.
Yeah.
and we got the result we needed. It was a massive result.
We did. Big result for Bilic, right?
Oh, definitely. I think he might have been gone had we lost today. But
yeah.
Hopefully we can go to Middlesbrough next week, at least get minimum point. Then
yeah. Well, it's cold here today. It'll be bloody cold in Middlesbrough. But yeah. You know what? Thank you, Liam. There we go. I'm going to switch off now. I'm going to have a few drinks. That's a lovely view. It's a particularly lovely view after a 3-0 win.